Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So in the previous class, we were discussing class B amplifier. Okay, right? We were discussing class B amplifier. Under class B amplifier, we have seen two categories: class P push-pull amplifier. Okay, then class B complementary symmetry amplifier. We have seen these two. Okay. Now what we are going to see is we are going to see the advantages and disadvantages of these two class B amplifiers. Okay. So first, the advantages of class B push-pull amplifier. Okay. This amplifier. Okay. This amplifier which has here two transformers. Okay, so next we are going to see, we are going to see advantages of this particular, okay, anyway, so we are going to see the advantages of class B push-pull amplifier. So the advantages we have here are, efficiency is much higher, right? Class A series FET we got 25%, transformer coupled we got 50%, class B we are getting 78.5. Which is much greater than 25% or 50%, isn't it? Right? So this is common for this 78.5% is common for both the class B amplifiers. The complementary symmetry amplifier as well as push-pull amplifier. For both these class B amplifiers, the efficiency is 78.5. So the important advantage, higher efficiency compared to class A. Then we have discussed that by using a transformer, there is a resistance reflected at the input side. Isn't it? So because of that, by adjusting the windings of the transformer, we can have the control over the resistance reflected at the primary side of the transformer. So that will help us, to achieve impedance matching. So two important advantages: high efficiency, impedance is matching because of the using of the transformers. Disadvantages: we are using two transformers. Big disadvantage is the circuit, we are using two transformers, first transformer, second transformer. So this is a disadvantage, and the other disadvantage is the frequency response, is poor, Frequency response, transformer is a frequency dependent component, For different frequencies, it behaves different, So, because of that, the frequency response is poor. So, all the disadvantages due to the transformer, two transformers, so more number of components, Usually the transformers are large in size. So due to transformer, circuits becomes bulky, The size of your circuit will be very large. Then again, because of the transformer, the frequency response is poor. Then, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of the class B push-pull amplifier, Next, we are going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of complementary symmetry class B amplifier. So first, the advantages, main advantage, see here, this is the complementary symmetry amplifier, no transformers, isn't it? So big advantage, the first very important advantage is, okay, as the circuit is transformer less, weight, size, cost are less. Okay, right? Then here just observe the configuration, okay, the transistor configuration in any of this circuit. P, okay, output we are taking at emitter terminal, okay, and the DC we are connecting to collector. From AC point of view, you know that the DC connection, you can approximate it to be ground, okay, right? So what we have here is, what we have, okay, here is that this is common collector configuration, because for AC equivalent, we will consider, okay, the DC source as ground, isn't it? So many times we have discussed from first unit onwards. When we consider AC point of view, when we are viewing the circuit, AC point of view, the point where we connect the DC source, okay, we consider it as ground. For AC analysis, the point where we connect the DC source, we view it as ground. So this is like ground. Collector is grounded from AC point of view. Again, collector is grounded from AC point of view. Because the collectors are grounded, you know that ground is common for both input-output. Isn't it? See, input also you have ground, output also you have ground. So we can call this as common collector, because collector is grounded, common collector configuration. Okay. So the important advantage of common collector configuration is the output impedance is lower. Okay. The output impedance is lower in the case of common collector configuration. Okay. So because of that, we have the advantage. Common collector has low output impedance, and usually your load, for example, loudspeaker, okay, loudspeaker has very less resistance, 4 ohm, okay, 16 ohm, so on, very small value, okay, in the order of ohms. And because common collector provides lower, okay, output resistance, okay, there is impedance matching possible for this particular, okay, for this particular class B complementary symmetry amplifier. Why frequency response improves? Anybody answer? Why frequency response improves? What is the reason I told you previous circuit disadvantage? Okay, if you understood that, you will be able to answer. Please answer.
We don't have to change the signals.
Okay, once again, I will tell the previous explanation. Why frequency response? Okay, I am going to previous circuit. Okay, we are going to previous circuit. That is the, okay, we are going back to this one, class B push-pull amplifier. Here, the frequency response is poor because the transformers are frequency-dependent components. Okay, right? You know, inductor, capacitor, transformers, all these are frequency-dependent components. Okay, right? So, here, you know, for an inductor, j omega L, okay, right? Here you have primary winding, you have secondary winding, which gives the inductive effects, is it? Okay, so this is a symbol of an inductor, symbol of another inductor, I hope, okay, you can visualize that it gives inductive effect, okay, means, you know, for an inductor, j omega L, so the inductance, okay, or the impedance of the inductor depends on frequency, right? Okay, the impedance of the inductor depends on frequency. So what happens When you frequency response means if you change the frequency, how the circuit responds. That is frequency response. So when you gradually change frequency, for different frequency, this behaves differently. Okay, right? Suppose if you are designing an amplifier, okay, say, then what you want it, you want it to perform uniformly for all the frequencies, okay, right? Say for example, suppose you are fixing in your phone alarm at daily 7 o'clock, okay? So every day you want it to, right? You want it to make sound at 7 o'clock, isn't it? But if due to some problem, it is sometimes it is turning on at 6:30, sometimes it is turning on at 7:30. It's a problem, isn't it? Okay. Likewise, when we design amplifiers, we prefer that okay throughout the ranges of the frequency, it okay gives the constant gain, okay, right? But the transformers are frequency dependent components. So for different, this is like the problem just now I discussed. So to some problem, you are setting your, suppose you have a clock, okay, and you have set alarm. Due to some problem, daily at different times it is turning on, okay? This is not preferable, is it? So the problem with this circuit is because the transformer are frequency dependent components, for different frequencies we get different gain, okay? And because of that, the frequency response is poor. Now tell me, this is for first circuit, complementary push-pull transformer coupled amplifier, okay? Now we are going to second circuit. Okay. Once again, this is the first circuit. Okay, this is the first circuit, which is class B push-pull amplifier. This is the first circuit. Okay, class B push-pull amplifier. And the drawback is because the transformers are frequency dependent components, the frequency response is poor. Next, we are going for class B complementary symmetry amplifier. Okay, next we are going for class B complementary symmetry amplifier. Here, okay, do we have transformers? Yes or no? Do we have transformers? Can you see any transformers here? So what will happen to frequency response? Will it improve or will it deteriorate?
Improve, sir.
That's okay. So advantage, frequency response improves, okay, right? But there is one disadvantage. The disadvantage is we are using two sources, plus VCC, minus VCC, okay? We are making use of two voltage sources. That is one disadvantage. Okay. Right. Another disadvantage that we have here is, right. Now, see, we are giving input positive. Input we are giving, say first half cycle, positive half cycle. Then we are saying that Q1 will conduct, okay? Ideally, Q1 will start conducting at the input 0 volt itself. But practically that is not the case, okay? Right? Practically, there is some voltage lost. Transistor doesn't turn on immediately, whether it is transistor or whether it is diode, it does not, see, as soon as you apply voltage, it does not turn on immediately. When the voltage exceeds a voltage called cut-in voltage, then only the transistor or the diode starts conducting. Okay. For silicon transistor or silicon diode, the cut-in voltage is 0.7 volt. Okay, the cut-in voltage is 0.7 volt. Means, okay, input we are giving sinusoidal voltage. Input we are giving sinusoidal voltage, and the output will not be complete sinusoidal voltage. Only when the input crosses 0.7 volt, then only the transistor will start conducting and it will generate output. Okay. So because of this, what happens? Okay. What happens is the waveform at the output is not exactly as desired. Okay. See, input we are giving sine wave, but output we are not getting complete sine wave because this VBE given here, it is 0.7 volt. Okay. The VBE that is given here is 0.7 volt. Only when the input crosses 0.7, then only we'll get output. When the input is between plus 0.7 and minus 0.7, the transistors are off. Okay, right? The transistors are off. So, what happens? The output will be zero. Okay, the output will be zero. Then again, so what happens here? Okay, what happens during positive half cycle? Only when the input goes beyond, when V in goes above 0.7 volt for silicon transistor, then only we will get output waveform. Okay, so the output will not, okay, you will not get the sine waveform immediately. There will be some lapse in the signal, okay? And then the negative half cycle we will not get immediately. There will be some loss in the signal. And only when the input, okay, for the second transistor, only when the input goes below minus 0.7 volt for silicon transistor, then only this transistor, for we are discussing for second half cycle, okay? For second half cycle, when the input, the negative half cycle, okay, goes below minus 0.7 volt, then only the Q2 will start conducting and then only we will get the output waveform. So the output waveform will be like this. 0 plus 0.7. So we will get output waveform. Then again, minus between 0.7 to minus 0.7. No, transistors are off. Both the transistors are off. So the output will be zero. Now again, the magnitude of the, okay, negative half cycle is high. So then the transistor conducts and we will get the, okay, negative half cycle, but this also we already discussed. For positive half cycle, Q1 conducts, Q2 is off. For negative half cycle, Q1 is off, Q2 conducts. In addition to that, we are discussing this additional point, the problem, the disadvantage, okay, we have for this class B, okay, complementary symmetry class B amplifier, the disadvantage we have is the distortion. This distortion is called as crossover distortion. Can anybody tell me why it is called as crossover distortion? It is called as crossover distortion. Anybody tell me why it is called as crossover distortion?
Is it because it is half of the positive side and half of the negative side?
Yes, correct. Okay. So actually what is happening here is this distortion is occurring when it is crossing the x-axis, isn't it? Only when the signal is crossing the x-axis, right, we have this distortion. Hence it is called as crossover distortion. Okay, right? Okay, so we have seen the advantages, disadvantages of this, okay, class B amplifier, okay, right? Now, distortion, is it wanted or is it unwanted? Do we need to have distortion or do we need to eliminate distortion? Yes. Okay. We always need to eliminate the distortion. Okay. Right. So, anybody think and answer. See, so far we have discussed all types of biasing. Okay. The class A, class B, all categories of class A, class B we discussed. Right. Class A, because we are operating at the center of the load line, we are getting full, okay, signal. Class B, we are operating at cutoff, so we are getting only one half cycle, but the transistor need 0.7 to turn on. So again, in that one half cycle, some part is eliminated. How can we solve this problem? Anybody think and answer?
When the first half cycle comes at the output, so before minus 0.7, like before, sometimes if we turn on the voltage supply from the other side, that is negative supply.
Okay, you are close to that. Okay, you are close to that. Hint again, one more. Once again, I want all of you to think. This is very interesting. Okay. Again, I am going to class A. Okay. I am quickly going. Okay. First, let me discuss class B. Class B, we are operating here. Okay. Class B, we are operating here. Because we are operating here, we are getting only half cycle. Okay. Next. Class A, we are operating in the center of the load line. Because we are operating at the center of the load line, we are getting full signal irrespective of the loss in the transistor due to its cutting, okay, the VBE diode cutting voltage, irrespective of the loss, we are getting full signal. Okay, now can you think? See, it is like this. If you operate here, what will happen? You will get negative half cycle proper, positive half cycle will be clipped. Okay. Class B, we operated here, because of that, in the current, positive half cycle we got, negative half cycle was clipped. Okay. Now, again, to compensate that 0.7 volt, where we should operate? Can anybody think an answer? See, it is like this. Suppose you have 100 rupees, okay, right? But say traveling, you are losing 10 rupees and you are going to shop, okay? You are going to shop and the shopkeeper says the product is 100 rupees, okay? So you cannot buy. Now, what is the solution? While starting itself, how much money you should carry? Yes. Students. Very good. Okay. So 110, additional 10 rupees you have to carry. So what you are doing, the 10 rupees lost in travel, we are compensating by giving an additional value. Okay. Likewise, what we do is, because we are operating here, I hope all of you are able to see my screen, okay, clearly. Because we are operating here, there is loss. So what we do, we operate slightly above, okay, along the load line. We don't exactly operate at cutoff, okay, right? So now we are discussing how to avoid this crossover distortion. How to avoid this crossover distortion? Instead of operating at cutoff, okay, instead of carrying 100 rupees, you are carrying slightly greater than 100, 110 rupees required. Okay, right? So what we will, okay, what we will do here is, instead of operating at cutoff, the crossover distortion can be avoided by operating slightly above cutoff in the active region. Okay, right? So here, if we operate at cutoff, it is class B. Okay, slightly above, if you operate, what you can call it as center, you will call it at A, class A. Okay, at cutoff, we will call it as B. What do you want to name slightly above cutoff? We will call it as class AB amplifier. Okay, we will call it as the class AB amplifier. Okay, right. So the problem here is crossover distortion. Why we have this crossover distortion? Because of this loss in signal. Okay, why the signal is lost? The transistor take 0.7 voltage of the input to turn on. Only when the input crosses 0.7 voltage, the transistors are on. So because of that, we get this. So how to solve that? While biasing itself, we bias it not at cutoff, but slightly above cutoff. Okay, so that will eliminate the crossover distortion, right? And okay, such a case is called as, okay, such a case is called as class AB amplifier. Okay, such a condition where we are operating slightly above cutoff is called as the class, okay, called as the class AB operation. Okay, so now how to, okay, this is the circuit which will eliminate the crossover distortion. Okay, students, this is the circuit which will eliminate the crossover distortion. Right, I told you whether diode or whether the transistor, for silicon diode or silicon transistor, the cut-in voltage is 0.7. Okay, now observe the base of this transistor Q1. Okay, just observe the base of this transistor Q1. Observe the base of this transistor Q1, okay, and then emitter of this transistor Q1. Base is which region in this transistor? Anybody? In this transistor, the base is which region? Pass, please. First of all, this is which transistor? NPN. Okay. NPN, emitter base collector. So base is which region?
P region.
Emitter is which region?
P region.
Base is P region. Emitter? Emitter base collector. Okay. Emitter base collector. NPN. So this is N, this is P. Okay. So we have P region here. We have N region here. Okay. So actually, what we have here is we have a PN junction. Okay. We have a PN junction. Likewise, this is PNP. The bottom transistor is PNP transistor. Okay. So what we have here is at the top, we have PNP. So there is a PN. So there is a PN junction here. Okay. Right. So now what we are doing, the example I told you, you are traveling, okay, additionally you are taking the extra amount required for travel, okay. So what is that extra amount here is, we are representing in terms of the diode D1 and D2. There is a PN junction here at Q1, base is P, emitter is N, so there is a PN junction, and that PN junction causes a loss of 0.7 volt responsible for crossover distortion. How to compensate? Give an additional PN junction diode. Okay, this is like the extra 10 rupees that we are giving for travel, so that now you will be able to go to the shop and buy. Okay, right? So the lost signal here can now be compensated by this additional diode. Likewise, one more diode for the second transistor. Okay, likewise, one more diode for the second transistor. So this is the class B, okay, this is the class B complementary symmetry amplifier, okay, this is the class B, sorry, this is the class AB, this is the class AB complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier, okay. What is class B? Class B is simply this B in Q1, Q2, RL. Additionally, we are giving this setup of two diodes, okay, for the compensation of the VBE lost at the two transistors for each transistor, each diode. And of course, for the diode, we need to give supply, right? So that supply we are connecting via resistor R1 to plus VCC, R2 to minus VCC. Okay, and usually the two resistors values are the same. Okay, usually in design the two resistor values are chosen same, so that this is symmetry network, isn't it? When we do that, the crossover distortion will be properly eliminated. Okay, so we have seen the crossover distortion and how to avoid that, right? Simple, very easy. We have two PN junctions at the base emitter. Okay, that is the problem. Input we have given to base emitter. Instead of giving directly, put diodes. Of course, for diodes, we need supply. So, via R1, we are connecting to VCC. The other via R2, we are connecting to minus VCC. Very simple. Right, and such an amplifier is class AB amplifier. Okay, such an amplifier is class AB amplifier. Next, another case is also possible. Okay, right. Okay, let me first complete this complementary symmetry class AB. Okay, this is complementary symmetry class AB amplifier. Another, okay, instead of using diodes, there is one more technique we can use. The other technique that we can use is this one. Okay, we know each of the, okay, base emitter junction PN, base emitter PN junction, okay, it contributes to 0.7 volt loss. Then another base emitter, okay, this junction, another 0.7 volt loss. So the total loss is 1.4 volt. So this is like this. Okay, we are same travel example. You are going to shop to buy, you need additional 10 rupees for travel. So that we are supplying additional amount of voltage required is, okay, the additional amount of voltage required is 0.7 plus 0.7, 1.4 volt. Okay, okay, 1.4 volt is the additional voltage required. That additional voltage we can give, okay, by putting a resistor R2, and the values of the resistors should be chosen such that the voltage is 1.4 volt. Okay, this is one technique. Another technique is by connecting two diodes. Another technique is by connecting the two diodes which we have just seen earlier. Here also what happens, each diode gives 0.7, 0.7, 1.4, which is required for, okay, transistor 0.7, 0.7, transistor 0.7 plus 0.7, 1.4. Here each diode provides 0.7, so 0.7 plus 0.7, 1.4, right? The crossover distortion will be eliminated. Here also, instead of connecting two diodes, we are connecting one resistor, okay, and the value should be chosen such that it gives a value of 1.4 volt. Okay, so that is another technique. So two techniques, both of these will come under class AB amplifier. Okay, both of these will come under class AB amplifier. Okay, both of these will come under class AB amplifier, and the reason for that, okay, is if we look at the characteristics, okay, if we look at the characteristics of okay if we look at the characteristics and the load line, so what is happening here? Because of that additional 0.7, see, if we don't give that additional 0.7 for the transistor, we are operating at cutoff. But because we are operating, if we operate at cutoff, it is class B. We are operating slightly above cutoff, this is class AB. Okay, so by doing that, we are compensating.